figured I would get the 10 myths, that the biggest ones that I hear all the time. And I want to talk about those myths and if they're true or not. Believe it or not, some of them have a little ring to truth in them. And I think that'll mean a lot as well. Before I get started,
check out the sponsorship.
Today's video is brought to you by Manscaped. Okay, today's message is going to be very different. No ball shaving and no body double. Did you know one man every hour, every day is diagnosed with testicular cancer? Hey, I said no body double. April is National Testicular Cancer Awareness Month. Manscaped and I want you to listen to this very important message. Testicular cancer is the most common cancer in men 15 to 35. And I want all the guys to know you can check for this right at home. Hey, I said no doubles. You can perform simple, routine self-checks at home while enjoying Manscaped products you use every day, like their Crop Preserver Ball Deodorant, their Crop Mop Ball Wipes, and the Skin Safe Lawnmower 3.0 Body Trimmer. Visit www.manscaped.com to learn how you can support testicular cancer awareness. And also check out their Perfect Package Kit and their all-in-one collection of grooming products for the modern man. And yes, when you're Manscaped, you look your best. Get 20% off plus free shipping at manscaped.com/jewel. So let me jump right in. Okay, one, beat up the biggest guy on the first day to assert dominance. Bad, 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 and a myth. That'll get your ass fucking killed. Now, you probably heard about my story when I went into a county jail and I was the only one in that jail. I was a white guy and there were 32 black guys and it was right after Hurricane Andrew. And I knew I was gonna have trouble because I just felt it. You could feel tension, you could feel people looking at you. This is back in 1992. And the reason I remember it so well, it was in the Dade County Jail in Miami. And it was right after Hurricane Andrew, and I was arrested, and they were just throwing people in cells. They didn't give a fuck or whatever. Well, what I did was I went and I turned the channel, and I knew I was going to hit the biggest guy in there who said something first. It wasn't just going up and starting. He said something. I kind of pushed the button to do it, and I'll tell you the truth. When I hit that guy, and I hit it, and he doesn't go down, holy shit, man. I ended up breaking my hand. We got to fight. And I could barely talk. My throat was in so hard. It was a rough time. He was the house man. He was a big dude. But it did also get me the respect I needed in that prison at that time, or the jail. Now, if you go to a prison and do that, you just might get killed. So no, you don't go in there and look for the biggest guy to assert dominance. Who the fuck you think you are? You know, I often give advice on this all the time. And as I say, the first thing you do is you stay to yourself. If somebody picks on you, somebody is pushing your button and trying you. I mean, I've beat people for disrespect, leaving your shaving hairs in the sink just because I thought they were doing it to test me. I also hit a guy for changing a channel so bad and fucked him up because I think he was testing me. That's a whole different animal. If you're going to be tested, you might have to respond. But you don't just go up and hit somebody. That's the big myth. That's going to get your ass killed. First of all, who the fuck you think you are? One, you might get killed in that fight. Or you might just get stabbed. You don't know what it's about. Somebody else don't know what it's about. That's the quickest way to get your ass either killed or off the yard, is what they call. And that's exactly what that's to do. So that should take care of myth number one. Myth number two, prison isn't so bad for a gay man. Oh my God, is that a big myth. I don't care if you're gay, straight, bisexual, transgender. I don't give a fuck what you are. Prison is not good for anyone, number one. You know, I have heard, oh, I'm a gay guy, so all these hot guys are there and stuff like that. Not gonna happen. First of all, if you just think you're gonna go and get who you want in prison, one, you're gonna get killed. Two, you might get a disease. Three, you might be messing with somebody else's guy, girl, whatever you wanna call it, and get killed that way. It's the biggest myth in the world. And getting raped, I don't care if you're a girl or a guy, getting raped, and rape is wrong. Rape is power. Rape is a sign of violence and control and power. Rape isn't a sign of positive sexuality or, that's good. And let me just, you know, emphasize this. I'm not talking about you and your girlfriend role playing or whatever the hell you do. I'm just letting you know, rape is not anything to be messed with, or it's not fun at all. That's number one. So that's bullshit. You know, somebody also said in that same sentence, they said, oh, Larry, I listened to how you can make money in prison, and as a gay guy, I do all of them. I mean, do their laundry, I would cook for them and stuff. Let me tell you something. Just because you're gay doesn't mean you can do that. Number two, who do you think you are? You don't think you're gonna go in on somebody else's hustle? How about the other gay guy that's got the hustle for doing all the cells? And he says, yeah, okay, he'll stab you. Listen, prison is not a place to be to have any kind of normal relationship in any way. So no, it's not good for gay people at all. It's not good for anybody, and gay people probably especially. You're gonna be tried, you're gonna be picked on, you're gonna have people wanna mess with you in a lot of different ways. And it's not gonna be fun, I can tell you that. Number three, prisons bury the bodies of dead prisoners in the prison. You know, I heard that. I actually heard that one. And it all comes from what they call Potter's Field. Potter's Field is where they do bury people who have nobody who'll claim the body. And some prisons have what they call Potter's Field out in the way out. And they'll do that. You don't see that in the federal system at all. You'll see it in state systems and stuff like that. I think in Angola, in Louisiana, has a Potter's Field where they'll bury people who are not claimed and been in prison forever and have no loved ones or anything like that. So that is true, but they don't bury them in the prison. It would be kind of, where are you going to put them? Under the concrete? I mean, prison is not like it's a big field you're going out on. Prison is a concrete thing with walls and all that kind of shit. Again, Potter's Field, so I do get that question. But it is kind of a myth on the prison or in that prison. No, it's going to be outside. It could be the prison grounds. So, again, I said there's some ring to truth to some of these. Number four. When you sag your pants, it means you are available for sexual activity. That's not true. I mean, that's just a cultural thing with some kids that did that. Obviously, they wouldn't be treated so well. You'd see guards telling them to pick up their pants or whatever. Actually, in some prisons, you couldn't do that. You'd get thrown in a hole. But no, it's also, you know, I've been in prison a long time, and I used to hear this one because it's in movies. Oh, you know, put your hand in my pocket, or, you know, follow me around. I never seen that either. You're a punk, you're a punk, you're a guy, and you want that one, you do it, and you end up having the balls to say it. Is there a lot of sneaking around and all that kind of stuff? Absolutely, that's normal. You will see a lot of that, and that does happen. But no, just sagging your pants doesn't mean you're available. Just like on the streets, it's not something that you're available. You might be tried by some of the old school guys. Say, man, you got your pants, your ass, let me see your ass. Something like that. That might happen. But it's not, that doesn't mean you're available. It's not like a sign out there. You know, like put a ribbon on your car or some shit. No, it's not like that. Okay, next one. You have to shiv someone for initiations into a gang. Myth. Not true. Now, you might have to do something. There's beat-ins, they call them. You might have to smuggle drugs. You might have to be in a fight. You might have to test somebody. You might have to question a guard. You might have to do something. Just having to shiv somebody or shank them, shiv them, whatever you want to call it. No, that's not. I've never heard that, and I know a lot of gangs in prison. So it's not like you have to shiv somebody. I never heard of that, ever. Now, I did hear of, again, you know, you might have to protect your area in the prison, where you sit, the gang sits, somebody sits there, you might have to be the one that goes and moves them, and whatever happens after that, happens after that. But it's not a set rule, you have to shiv somebody, you know, like you have to murder somebody, or you have to do this. Now, there are gangs out there, and tough ones, Aryan Brotherhood, you know, that has a whole bunch of initiations that can be really rough. So, but that's a whole nother video in itself. Number six, you will get physically violated if you drop the soap in the shower. You know, this is the number one myth that I get. This one. Oh, if you're in the shower and you drop the soap, you're gonna get fucked in the ass. That's not true. I was in a shower with six men. Now, would I just drop it and stick my ass out? No. I don't want to give any kind of signs that I want to be fucked in the ass. Unless you want to be fucked in the ass. But no, I've never seen and heard even of that. Now I heard of rapes. I've heard of guys going to the shower, not going the right way, and somebody was after them. They went in there. I've heard rapes in prison. I've seen a lot of that. But not just dropping the soap and you're going to get fucked in the shower. First of all, in most prisons, you shower alone. Unless you're in a holdover or a hole and they take multiple people out to take a shower, like in Lewisburg. But in most prisons, it's a single shower. You think the guards want to start dealing with that kind of crap? They'll put you in a shower. It's crazy because they'll put you in a shower and then there'll be something happen on the yard and they'll go running away and you'll be in that shower for an hour, 2 hours, whatever. They don't give a shit. And 3 hours. They don't care. I mean, you were in there and you're locked in there. So no, it doesn't mean you're going to be physically violated. Not at all. But I wouldn't drop the soap in front of anybody and pick that soap up without squatting and going down, and or I wouldn't just bend over in front of people. I just wouldn't do that. Myth number 7. Everyone has a shank. You know, this is the one I had a little bit of thinking about, and I'll tell you why. A lot of people have shanks. Does everyone have a shank? No. But a lot of people do. And if you put it in your head that everybody's got a shank, you're going to walk a little bit more cautious. You're going to keep an eye out a little bit better. And it's not a bad thing. It's like being on the street and saying, wow, everybody's got a gun. Would you do something around here if you thought everybody had a gun? Probably not. In this case, a lot of people have shanks. And it's just what it is. It's prison. People have a weapon, especially a little guy. Maybe a guy who doesn't think he can defend himself. Or he's messing around in the drug game. Or the sex game. Or the gambling game. Or whatever. I always had shanks. I always had 3 of them. I even took one of the yard a few times. You know about that. And suitcasing it. So I had to do what I had to do in prison to protect myself. But not everybody has a shank. So I'm calling that half and half. I think it's a good idea if you think everybody has a shank. Because then you're going to act accordingly. And as you should anyway. And that's what will keep you alive. Not hitting the biggest guy in the prison. Number 8, prison guards will take their time to stop a fight if a chomo is getting beat up. Well, you know, let me explain. First of all, a chomo is a child molester. They're not liked in prison as if rats are not liked in prison. They're the lowest of the low. Now, this one I told you has a ring of truth to it because I know guards who would take their time or slow walk, if they call it, to go to a fight if they know what it is. My buddy Gary Massey said he heard that Lawton was out front going nuts when I went nuts on the unit manager, and he didn't even go because he says, fuck her. He didn't like her. Not because of me. He didn't like her. So he said, fuck it, you know, and he knew that the person down there and the person taking me to the hole was a guy named Spell. He knew I was okay. He knew I wasn't gonna get fucked up. He knew the system wasn't gonna fuck me up. And that was Jessup, Georgia. Again, I have seen guards and no guards that they would do that. So that's on that end. Number 9, there is always an old wise guy that can give you advice. You know, I'm almost gonna say that's true. If you seek it out in prison, if you seek out advice from somebody in prison, and they're an old timer, and there are old timers in every prison, you know, the OGs, I became one after being in prison for so long. Paul Tolini was a guy people would seek out advice. But yes, so I'm gonna say that's almost not a myth. There is always an old guy that can give you advice and will give you advice. Obviously, not if you're a dick. Not if you come off like, hey, I need this, give me that. You gotta have, you know, the key to prison and all of this stuff and this whole list is respect. You give respect and you get respect. That's it. You give it and you get it. Because there's always someone in there who don't give a fuck. Might feel slighted. Might have heard some bad news at home. Don't give a shit if he's gonna die. Whatever the cause. So you gotta think like that as well. So, but that old guy in that prison will give you the rundown of the prison. He'll get to know you and you'll know him and you can go to him and say, hey, listen, what would you do? And he might give you some old stories about him when he was a young kid and stuff. And he, you know, he's been in prison. He's an old timer. I've been in prison till I know what they're gonna do to you anyway and all this shit. Don't waste your time or whatever. Now you gotta take that advice, put it in here, filter out the crazy shit, because they all have it, and let that come out the other ear and keep the good shit. But I would agree 100% that there is an old guy in every prison that's gonna help you and give you advice if you want it and if you act accordingly. Number 10, there is always a kingpin in prison. You know, that's another one that's got half truths to it, or it's kind of worded a little bit differently. Now, there's always what they call shock callers in prison. Now, each gang or group have shock callers. Now, are they the kingpin? Not necessarily. They might have came up in rank or whatever it is in their gang or group, and they then are the kingpin of that group. Now, in the prisons I was in, now this is maximum security prisons in the federal system, which had money, meaning prisoners. The feds didn't go after you if you were a little, little robber or some shit. They went after you if you were a big-time criminal or a big-time drug dealer or a kingpin or a big-time money launderer. And even those are down at a lower security. So the big guys are mafia bosses and drug kingpins. There is always a kingpin, at least in the prisons that I went to. There's always a kingpin or a big drug. In our prison in Atlanta, the biggest drug deal we had was Willie Falcone. Now, Willie Falcone was the biggest drug dealer in the world, worth $1 billion. They were drug kingpins, for sure. So that does happen. And there will be kingpins and there will be stuff like that in prison. So I don't think there won't. You know, I wanted to debunk these myths because some of them are great questions and some of them, as you can see, are not myths, whether it's the old man or the kingpin. And there's other ones, dropping the soap or hitting the first guy. That's the biggest, stupidest thing you can do. Those things, you have to find out the right way, right here. So think before you act. I always believe that. You know that. Don't ever just think you're the toughest guy in the prison, because you're not. I don't care how tough you are. You're not the toughest guy in that prison. Someone will stab you, kill you, catch you off guard, do whatever it is. You could be a tough guy, because I know a lot of tough guys in prison. But I'm talking about the real deal guys, and you know what I mean. So the guys that can fight, MMA fighters, boxers, this kind of stuff, you'll still get killed. You don't give the person the right respect in prison, you're gone. There's your myth there. You're not the toughest guy in the prison. Always remember that. And the one who acts like it is usually not the one either. He's the one that has to do that for bravado or some other bullshit. Now, that's it. That happens. One other myth I'm going to give you right off the top of my head is, people ask me this all the time, do the guards really segregate inmates? Yes, they do, in their own way. And they rather see whites fight blacks, Hispanics fight blacks, Hispanics fight Asian, Hispanics fight white, whatever it is. They rather see more conflict like that than they rather see everybody get together and control the prison. Because they know at any one good time, if we all got together, we could take that prison over anytime we want. That's a fact. That's not a joke. There's no guns in prison. You know that. The only guns they have is in the towers. They don't have guns on that yard. No guard carries a gun. No guard carries anything like a weapon at all. They carry a radio. They don't carry weapons. Always remember that. They have the authority of the prison. I think that pretty much covers the 10 myths about prison. I hope you learned something today. I love doing these. I want you to make good choices, people. That's the key to this whole game. You know, make good choices. Learn from me. Don't go to prison. Got a lot of great videos we've been doing. Hometown videos, everything. You know, a bunch of stuff coming out. Have a great day, everybody. Stay strong. And please, make good choices and do something good for somebody today. Have a great day, everybody. Ciao.